Hi friends, welcome to Discover Agriculture YouTube channel. If you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe now. Integrated rice, fish and poultry farming, apart from being helpful in generating some revenue, also helps in weed control by 40% and pest incidence by 30% in paddy crops. Resource poor farmers adopting low input agriculture are the main beneficiaries of this system. The simple reason is that it offers multiple benefits like biocontrol of pests, infestations, weeds, and better crop growth because the fish feed on the pests and insects attacking the rice plant, and poultry droppings are constantly washed into the field making it more fertile and conducive for healthy crop growth. There is plenty of data available on rice-fish-poultry integrated model in several universities across the country. But if you study closely, you will find that in an acre, a pond would have been dug and a poultry cage erected over it. The paddy crop will be grown in a plot adjacent to this. There will be no connection to all three activities. But in our model, we have carefully planned to avoid such a gap and implemented it in such a way that all three are connected to each other. Replicating this model is quite easy. For example, in an acre, beneficiary farmers are growing paddy in 90 cents. They grow fishes like grass carp, common carp, rogue, kitla in a trench on all sides of the field. In the remaining 5 cents, poultry cages propped up on concrete poles are erected fitted with wire meshes. The cage is erected in such a way that a part of the cage is above the water-filled trench and the remaining part over the paddy crop. A part of the bird droppings falls directly into the water as feed for fishes and the remaining on the fields as manure for the crop. During the single rice cropping season, about 5 to 6 months, poultry can be reared 3 times. Common NPK fertilizer schedule for rice is being followed as basal input, but farmers are cautioned not to practice split application of the chemical fertilizer as it may affect good fish growth. Also, as plant protection measures, neem kernel extract is used instead of spraying chemical insecticides. Compared to other livestock wastes, poultry wastes have inherent qualities that make them particularly valuable for fish and crop production. Poultry wastes are higher in nutrient than other livestock wastes. They have been found to contain less moisture, fiber and compounds such as tannins that discolor water when used as fish pond fertilizer. For widespread adoption, maximization of potential and effective pond management in this kind of farming system, here are requirements. Information on the volume of different animal manures that should be applied in the fish pond, the proper stocking density, water quality, types of nutrients in the pond and their volumes, and feed conversion ratio. Hope you like this video. Share this video with all friends and don't forget to subscribe Discover Agriculture channel. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.